Hello and welcome to Python Fundamentals. In this course, we learn the underpinning Python programming skills, preparing for our journey towards mastering the Django framework and the Python programming language. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. This tutorial is from our Python Programming Fundamentals for Django Developers course, which you can find and purchase on Udemy. You will find all the latest and updated tutorials, as well as resources and assessments to help accelerate your learning of the subject. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. In the previous tutorial, we saw a very high-level view of the Django request response cycle. In this tutorial, we take the first step of building our new web page by creating a URL. We learned in the previous tutorial, Django request response cycle, that the user types in a URL and that needs to be matched within our Django project in order for us to then return a resource back to the user. If the user were to type in a URL that doesn't exist within our app, they'll likely then be returned some sort of error. What we also learned in the previous tutorial is that Django has a URL already defined when we create a new Django project, and that's the admin page. So we can see here that admin slash, that is the URL that can be matched to access the admin page. So let's just go through that process again of utilizing this admin path URL to match and view the admin page. So if you haven't already done so, let's go ahead and migrate. So this will migrate, this will create all of the different tables that are required in order to access the admin page. So we'll talk more about migrations later on, but just make sure you run that command. Now I've already migrated, so you may see a different output on your screen. So once we've done that, let's go ahead and run the server. If we open up a new window in our browser and then enter the URL of our application, that takes us to the default page. Now what we want to do is extend the URL. So you may not be able to see this. One second. So again, it's very small, but what I'm doing here is I've typed in 12701:8000, the default URL, and now I'm going to type in slash admin. So this URL is going to be matched against this URL here, and then it's going to be then starting this resource, or it's going to be then initiating the code that's connected to this resource here. And that is the Django admin site. So one of the first things to understand about URL patterns is that the blank URL pattern refers to the root directory. So let's just go back here to admin. At the moment, admin resides on this path admin slash. If I change that to blank here, then we have now changed where the admin site can be accessed. So let's go back here to slash. So notice here that this is our, we're now using our home URL, which is just 12701:8000. But you notice that the admin site is now being presented on this page and not the home page anymore. And that's because we've changed the URL. So we can define our own URLs. So let's go for example, admin site. What we need to remember here is that the forward slash goes at the end and not at the start. Okay, so admin sites, we've changed where the admin site will now be accessed. So let's go back into our page here. If I refresh, you can now see we have the home page being shown again. Now, if I type in slash and then admin site, that then takes you to the admin site. So that is now on slash admin site. You will notice some other information here. I'm just going to ignore that for now. So we don't need to know anything about that just yet. But that's the admin site. So if we want to build a new resource You can see that we're going to need to define two parameters here. So we need the actual path that we're going to be utilizing. So if we were going to build an about us page, about us slash, for example, that might be utilized. And then we're going to need to connect this new URL to some sort of view. So you can see that inside the core, the main project folder here, we have URLs. But what we're going to do now is we're going to extend this over to our new app. What we're trying to do here is contain all the information about our new app inside the new app folder here, so that anytime we want to make any changes, it's always going to be found within this app. It's going to make it easier to manage potentially and find and debug. So what I can do here, instead of writing a new path here and new URL, etc., what I can do is I can extend this list by importing another list. So in the new app here, I can create a new file called urls.py. Now you can call it whatever you like, but it seems quite uniform to call it urls.py to match the name of the core URLs. Okay, so I can make that. And what I can do is I can add a list here of URLs, and I can import this list into the main URL file here. So when Django goes through the process of looking and matching for URLs, it will first of all look for this one, and then it would go down to this, which will then be connected to our new URLs page, and then go through this list of URLs that might be on this page, and then continue if there's any other paths underneath that. So let's connect our new URLs file that we've created here in the new app folder. Let's connect it to the main URLs in the core project folder. Okay, right. So first of all, we need to bring in a different resource, and that is going to be include. So this is a resource which is going to allow us to include or bring in import other files here, in this case, urls.py. So now we can build a new path. So let's start off with the empty path. So anytime someone just goes to our main URL, then this is going to be fired off. So we need a comma here, and now we need to connect it to a view. So let's go for include here, because in actual fact, we want to connect this to other URLs. So now we just need to specify where the file is stored. So in this case, it's going to be new app, and then we use dot. So here I've referred to this folder here, our new app, and then inside of this folder, dot, and then we're looking for URLs. So this is the resource, URLs. So the include in Python is a function that takes a full Python import path to another URL config module. So here, for example, we've used include to import the data that's going to be found in this URLs here. And we've just added it right here. So like I said previously, Django will then, first of all, search for this URL to make a match, and then find all the URLs in this resource here and make matches if there's any matches here inside of this URL file. So that's the first step. The second step is now to build a new URL inside of our URLs inside the new app folder here. So we can take the resource here from Django URLs, URLs import path. So let's bring that in. And then in addition to that, we can just copy it and paste the URL patterns here, speeds things up a little bit. And then we can go ahead and just remove those and build a new path. So we would like to build a new resource for our web page, and that's going to be the home page. So let's use the knowledge that we learned earlier. So blank, if there's nothing inside of this path, that means that is referring to the index page, the home page of our website. So now what's going to happen on our website, if we navigate to the home page, it's then going to utilize these URLs. Okay, so let's go into our URLs And now we need to define a resource that's going to be used when a user accesses the home page. So again, if we type in the doubles here, and now what we need to do is we need to connect this resource to a view. Now at the moment, we don't have any views. So let's go ahead and from dot, let's import views. So this will give me access to all the views inside of the views here, which we'll see in the next tutorial. So by doing that, that will then make those resources available. And what I need to do next is then connect these views to a view name, a function that we're going to create in the views file.